When Allah sees that one kind of corruption comes out in a person, one kind of sin they don't care about, then Allah opens doors to other sins, and He makes those other sins just right accessible to them. And He wants to see, are you actually remorseful for the other smaller deeds, other corruptions that you're engaged in? Are you want to walk away from them? Or do you want, if other doors were open to other corruption, you do that too? You would do that, you take that also, you jump at it too. And Allah says, this is how we tested them, because of the corruption they used to engage in. Meaning these kinds of tests sometimes come to people that that dabble in sin, that engage in corruption, and they don't walk back from it. Anybody can make a mistake. When you make a mistake, you make tawbah, you walk back. But if you refuse to walk back, and you keep being corrupt and corrupt and corrupt and corrupt, then Allah opens doors to even worse haram for you. Now why would Allah do that? Allah does that in other places He describes, that إِنَّمَا نُمْلِي لَهُمْ لِيَزْدَادُوا إِثْمًا. Like Allah extends their rope for them so they can earn even more sins. I always give the same analogy when I describe this principle of the Quran. When Allah allows people to keep going, وَيَمُدُّهُمْ فِي طُغْيَانِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ, He keeps extending them in their rebellion. The analogy my teacher gave me is still stuck in my head. He gave the analogy of a dog. If you have a dog on a leash that's 1 foot long, the dog wants to run, it can't, because the leash keeps tugging at him, right? So what the owner does to punish the dog, instead of giving him a 1 foot leash, he gives him a 200 foot leash. It's still a leash, it's still tied to the tree, and the dog thinks it's free for 199 feet. Until he hits the 200th foot, what happens to him? He gets choked so hard because he was running so fast, you understand? So the 1 foot leash was actually safer for the dog, the 200 foot leash actually kills him, destroys him. You want to rebel? Go ahead. You think you don't have a leash on you? Go ahead and run. See how far you go. And the further you go, the harder the choke will be at the end. That's the idea. Allah says, you want this? Then I'll give you. You know? نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى, Quran says. We'll turn him in the direction he turns into. You want to turn in a certain direction? Okay. I'll open up all the doors that the road you want to take. Allah will not stop you from taking a road. As a matter of fact, someone wants to take the right road, Allah will open more doors for them in the right direction. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. Somebody wants to take the wrong road, Allah will open more doors and more wrong and more wrong. Go ahead, take it, take it, take it. He's not making you do it, He's giving you the choice. You can walk away from any of them at any point. But the other important thing before we get to the next ayah, and maybe we won't get to it today, maybe in the next week I'll cover this more, you know, in depth, the response and what happens in this story. But today what I wanted to highlight is a kind of test that you and I have to be ready for from Allah Azza wa Jalla. And what's that test? That test is that the halal, the right way, may seem like it requires more work. It requires more effort. It's not as convenient. And the wrong way is actually wide open and extremely tempting and super convenient and effortless. Where the good, the benefit that you're seeking from the halal, the haram way, if you do the right thing, you have to make a lot of effort for it to, you don't have to, it won't come to you, you have to go to it. But the haram, you don't even have to go to it, it's coming to you, like the fish are coming to you, right? You don't have to go to them, they're coming to you. تَأْتِيهِمْ حِتَانُهُمْ شُرَّعًا. So when something is wrong, sometimes Allah will have that, the test to you and me will be, it'll be knocking on your door. Hey, you don't have to come pursue me, I'll pursue you. The fish is saying, come hunt me. You know, you don't have to catch me, I'll come to you. I'll jump right in your basket, you know. So this idea is a very powerful one. We have to look out for this test, because are we people that run after convenience? And as a result of looking for convenience or quickly fulfilling what we desire, whether it's money or lust or anything else, whatever we desire, there's a halal road to take and that road may be difficult, and there's a haram road to take and that's super convenient and extremely tempting. And it whets the appetite, and someone says, I should just go for that, it's so much easier. Why am I making things hard on myself? Why even put myself through that difficulty? This is how Allah tests not disbelievers. Remind yourself, this is how Allah tests a believing community. These were a believing community. They believed in revelation.